Now, there were folks who somehow believed that thermite had something to do with it. Well, let's see if we can make some. You have a steel structure, the towers, with aluminum cladding. Let's see if you grind them up. And you end up with rust and aluminum powder. You know what that is? Thermite. Those are the ingredients of thermite. So those ingredients are going to be there anyway. But what does thermite do? Well, here's a test of thermite here. Welding a railroad track.
Blinded by the light.
There was something missing in Manhattan that day. People weren't blinded by the light. You know, if there was nukes that went off, people would be blinded by the light. That's how they weld railroad tracks. You know, how do you have, you know what a sparkler is, 4th of July sparkler? That's what the towers would look like also if it was thermite, you know, doing things. It doesn't do it in the dark. Right, but it's not like, you know, thermite. That's another thing to talk about later. There is something, you know, I call them sparkles and sprinkles. But let's, you know, there's a whole lot of different things that, different areas, but that is a good thing to notice. Now, there's hot directed energy weapon systems and there's cold ones. And looking at all, you know, some people need to see things in a data table. We have low heat, unburned paper, low seismic impact, minimal debris, you know, bathtub survives. Material specific effects, you know, door latches, trunk lids, toasted cars at a distance, tritium without ionizing radiation. It doesn't have ionizing radiation. Dustification. There's really only one thing that fits the bill. I'm not going to describe exactly what gizmo it is, but we're knowing its characteristics. And its characteristics are amazing. We could use this for free energy. Directed energy weapon, rather than kinetic energy. These are kinetic energy weapons, heat and motion. You know, wrecking balls, bombs, missiles. This is from 1989. Science by press conference. This
is it a shortcut to fusion energy? I don't want to disappoint anyone. I think I'll put my read my lips answer here, and then I'll carry on. That, I think that'll become clear why I'm saying that. Can you read my lips on that back in the back? It says no. Energy is a long way off. That's why I say no. This is our result. It's just way off. I think a door that's open to us, but really a door on physics more than on energy. Geophysics in particular could be an interesting area.
Don't go there. Don't research there. But then he calls for a vote. And he holds up his hand. Let's vote to destroy the careers of Pons and Fleischmann and vote that it's not science. Why I'm bringing this up is we want to be sure this doesn't happen again. Harry raises his hand. Department of Energy funding. And we have Steve Coonan, who was just appointed by the first administration of Obama to an undersecretary of the Department of Energy. And these guys are thinking about raising their hand. And peer pressure causes people to do things like this too. If everyone else holds their hand up, you start holding your hand up. You don't want to be caught not holding your hand up. But they're determining science by vote.
opportunism, Jones insisted on going public quickly with his comparative opportunism. Jones insisted on going public quickly with his comparative opportunism. Jones insisted on going public quickly with his comparative opportunism. Jones insisted on going public quickly with his comparative.
All right, let's stick there. Now, let's look. The building turned to dust. Something did that. People say, well, you don't know of a technology that did that, so therefore it didn't, you know, happen. Wait, you start out with determining what happened first. It's very important, because if you start out with what you know, you won't get there because you've never seen this before. But we know it happened, so therefore, there is a technology that exists that can do this. That technology can also be used for free energy. Now let's vote on that. The tower's gone. So this is more of determining facts. Did they mostly turn to dust? There exists a technology that instead of molecules being attract each other, they repel each other. What happened is not impossible, because it happened. This is another Charlie Pound song about gatekeepers.
The data says that some form of directed electromagnetic energy was used to basically break down the materials of the World Trade Center, and the connections that Jones has between the cold fusion experience that everybody can read about in Dr. Mallove's book, and with what's going on right now with the 9/11 situation, it's just a mirror image of him muddling up and then, you know, trying to get public opinion against, you know, whoever his target is. In this case, it's Dr. Judy Wood. In the previous case, it was Pons and Fleischmann.
The important part is to realize we don't want history to repeat. People tend to mindlessly follow the herd. Remember about the problem with groupthink. You think that this person knows what they're talking about, and everybody joins in, and look what it cost us. That was 1989, and it took 20 years to somewhat vindicate Fleischmann, but it was too late. And we don't want that to happen again. And it's very important for each one of us to hang on to our own thoughts. Be independent. And otherwise, people get herded off to one side or the other. But what I see here is a lot of similarities with the tritium. What on earth would tritium be doing at the World Trade Center without the ionizing radiation? Yeah, it has transmutation, a lot of other things. Anyway. That's it. Thanks. Thanks for caring.